Good morning, students. We are going to discuss today about change of state. Change of state. Change of state means changing from one state into another, either by absorption of heat energy or by release of heat energy. Let us see what happens when there is change in the heat energy in the matter. It will result into the change of the state. So first we can come to melting, which is also called fusion. It is the process in which a solid will change into liquid by the release of heat energy, by the absorption of heat energy at a fixed temperature. So there will always be change in the solid into liquid when heat energy is absorbed. And as I said, this process takes place at a fixed temperature, like for example ice when changes into water. During the process of melting, there is no change in the temperature. Ice, which is at 0 degrees Celsius, will remain as same, which is at 0 degrees Celsius, even it changes to water. Second is just reverse of this process, which is called freezing or solidification. Freezing or solidification. Now it is the process in which liquid changes into solid. Liquid changes into solid after the release of heat energy. So this is the process where heat energy will be released. Like water changes into ice. Here also there is no change in the temperature. Water, which is taken at 0 degree Celsius, even when it changes into ice, the temperature remains same. And the temperature at which liquid changes into a solid state is called freezing point. Next is vaporization or boiling. Third process is boiling process, which is also called vaporization. And this is the process in which liquid changes into gas at a fixed temperature after the absorption of heat energy. Here also heat energy will be absorbed, like water after absorbing heat energy, it boils and it changes to gas. And the temperature at which liquid boils at a fixed temperature is called boiling point. Where if you take water which boils at 100 degree Celsius, there is no change in the temperature. Next we can come to the process called condensation. Condensation, which is also called liquefaction, where it is the process in which the gas will change into liquid. Gas changes into liquid after the release of heat energy. In this case, the heat energy will be released and the temperature at which condensation takes place is called condensation point. Next, coming to sublimation. We have the next process, which is called sublimation. Now this is the process where a solid will directly change into a gas without changing into liquid. Of course, in this case also heat energy will be absorbed. Solid changes directly into liquid, gas without changing into liquid. We have many examples like iodine, camphor, ammonium chloride. Then we have a very good example like dry ice, which is a solid form of carbon dioxide, will directly change into gas. And the last process we have, evaporation. It is also a process where you find liquid changing into gas. But in this case, the conversion will take place at any temperature. Like when you dry clothes, you have to keep that clothes in the sun so that water in the clothes would evaporate and the drying of clothes would take place. You might have seen small drop of water or small pool of water on the floor. It also dries due to the evaporation process. So these are the different processes which results into the change in the state of matter. Thank you.